Hello, my name is Dean Banerjee. I'm with the Frequency Control Products Division of Texas Instruments. Today, we're going to be talking about phase noise and some of the techniques we use to measure it. Phase noise is important for communication systems because it impacts the jitter, bit error rate, and signal-to-noise ratio. To measure phase noise, we need to understand that the loop bandwidth of the system impacts the values it has. So I'm going to start first with some of the transfer functions. So the noise has basically three different classes. One is the noise from the input, whatever is being used. The input could be a crystal, an XO, recovered clock, or many other possibilities. This input noise is low-pass filtered up to the loop bandwidth. Then beyond the loop bandwidth, it is attenuated. The PLL noise, which consists of noise from the charge pump and dividers, is low-pass filtered and then attenuated after the loop bandwidth. Finally, the VCO phase noise is actually high-pass filtered, so below the loop bandwidth it is attenuated, above the loop bandwidth it passes through. So discussing VCO phase noise, here's a typical plot of what the VCO phase noise looks like. Recall the VCO phase noise is high-pass filtered, so if you want to measure it, you need to have a narrow loop bandwidth. There's two techniques to get a narrow loop bandwidth. One is to design a loop filter with a narrow loop bandwidth. Or another technique that's often used is to simply set the charge pump to either a very low gain or just turn it off completely. Either way gives you a very narrow loop bandwidth. The second noise source, input phase noise, comes from the input. And the critical thing to remember on this is this noise is scaled from whatever input frequency to the output frequency. So for instance, in this case, if I have a 20 megahertz input frequency and a 480 megahertz output frequency, this noise is measured by 20 log of 24, or 14 dB increase in the phase noise. So if you want to see the impact of this on your system and you have a wide loop bandwidth, this noise is going to go straight through. So for measurement purposes, you want a wide loop bandwidth. The PLL noise actually has two critical noise components. We have a figure of merit and a flicker noise. The flicker noise can be thought of as a noise acting at 10 kilohertz offset, and it changes as 10 dB per decade and changes at 20 log of VCO frequency. And of course, it's affected by the loop filter shaping. That's one component of the phase noise. The flat noise can be characterized as a figure of merit plus 20 log of N over D. So N is the feedback ratio, and D, if there happens to be an output divider, you can factor this in the N counter. And then plus 10 log of phase detector, and then this is also shaped by loop filter. And then if you turn on the fractional modulator, it can add its own noise, which is independent of these other two sources. So in this example, we see here's the flicker noise changing at 10 dB per decade, and then it hits a flat noise, and these two add together. And then past the loop bandwidth, it gets shaped by this transfer function. If we look at some of the datasheet numbers, for instance, on the LMX2571, this has a figure of merit of minus 231 and has a flicker noise of minus 124, so that's normalized to 10 kilohertz and 1 gigahertz output. So now what I'd like to do is actually measure some of this PLL figure of merit and 1 over F noise, and also just take a quick look at the VCO phase noise. So I have my code loader software here, which loads all LMX and LMK devices. Here you can see I've set the charge pump to a very high gain. I've used a high phase detector frequency. I have 100 megahertz input, 4800 megahertz output, dividing by 5 at 960 megahertz output. So let's go look at our setup here.
To measure the PLL phase noise, we're going to start with a Wenzel 100 megahertz crystal. This is very, very clean. It's high output power plus 14 dBm. And we can be sure that this particular instrument is not going to disrupt our PLL phase noise measurements. It's going to be well below the PLL phase noise. The output here is at plus 14 dBm. It's going to go through this limiter, which is going to limit the amplitude of the signal, but not degrade the slew rate. And then this is going to come in all the way to the LMX2571, which is here. You may notice that there is an oscillator also on this board, but this is disconnected and powered down. This is the LMX2571, which is outputting the signal, which is going out to this SMA connector. And this SMA connector is connected to the Agilent E5052 phase noise analyzer. Coming back to the board, we also have an unused output here, which is powered down. And for power, we use a 3.3 volt power supply, which comes in through this SMA connector. So first of all, let's look at the flicker noise. So if we look at our phase noise analyzer, we see we have noise at 100 hertz of minus 106.2, and at 1 kilohertz, 115.5. So let's go and take these numbers and let's calculate what this means as a normalized flicker noise. So I have a little Excel worksheet here, and I'm going to go to here, and I'm going to delete these numbers here, and let's type in what we have. So 100 hertz right now, minus 106.1 is what I see on the scope right now. And at 1 kilohertz, I see minus 115.5. So if I normalize these at 100 hertz and 1 kilohertz, the first one normalizes at 126.1, the other one 125.5. Average them together, 125.8. Now this is at 960 megahertz, and I really want to do the phase noise measurement at 1 gigahertz. So when I normalize this number to 1 gigahertz, I get 125.4. Data sheet claims minus 124, but I have a very low noise Wenzel crystal, a very good setup, and I'm able to achieve minus 125.4. Now, if we look at the flat noise, let's go and clear this out and see what we get. So let's go to the flat noise here on our oscilloscope. At 200 kilohertz, I see a number of minus 131.5. So I'm going to take my little Excel worksheet here. I take minus 131.5. So my raw number is minus 131.5. However, you noticed over here I did this side calculation to see what the flicker noise would be at 200 kilohertz offset, would be 138.8. So if I subtract away the flicker noise to just get to the raw flat noise, I actually get minus 132.4, which is 0.9 dB higher, just a small correction. Now if I take this number, subtract away 20 log N over D, subtract away 10 log phase detector, I get a figure of merit of minus 232. And recall, these are the functions we talked about. And what I'm doing is I'm actually working these formulas back, or go from a measurement to the metric, where these formulas go from the metric to the measurement. Now that we've measured the PLL noise, let's just take a quick look at the VCO noise. Recall the VCO is high pass filtered. So to measure it, we want a narrow loop bandwidth. To do that today, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to disable the charge pump. So to do that, let's go over to the code loader software and let's go ahead and turn off the charge pump. So I'm going to set this thing to the tri-state for the up and the down. And then let's go over to our measurement equipment and reset the averaging and see what we get. So here, now we have the raw VCO phase noise, 1 megahertz minus 139.2, and we can see the VCO phase noise without the impact of the PL shaping that. Today, we've talked about phase noise, how to measure it, and how it's impacted by the loop bandwidth. Be sure to visit the following web addresses at Texas Instruments for more information.